We're here with Dave Cota. Time for a fall update. What's happening with the town of Carabasset Valley? Dave is the town manager, although not for long. You're going to be retiring next year. Boo-hoo. Don't even want to think about that.
I don't either.
That's not what we're talking about today. With COVID going on, we haven't had the normal chance to get out and about and talk as a community, formally or informally, so we thought it was a good time to have WSKI share with taxpayers, locals, those who want to be, as the RAC says, find out what's going on in the valley. You've helped by making a list of bullet points, which is all items we want to talk about. One of the items that's been talked about, which nobody wants to talk about, is the Penobscot Indian land closures. Where are we with that situation at this point in time?
Yeah, it's kind of discouraging, quite frankly, Nadine. We've had, since early this spring, they've shut off access to all of their roads and all of the trail systems that are within the town of Carabasset Valley. I mean, you know, we believe it's because of the town's opposition to legislative docket 1628, which the 130th legislature dealt with last year, which will come back for hearings in front of the state's judiciary committee again in January. The town is opposed to that legislation, which would have essentially allowed the tribes to either buy land or convert their existing fee land in Maine from fee land to federal trust lands without a vote of the town. That's the key point. The 1980 Indian Lands Claim Settlement Act recognized the ability of tribes to be able to acquire land and put their lands in federal trust lands, but in those towns that were organized, in organized towns, it required a vote of the town, and this legislation would have eliminated that. It's huge, and Carabasset Valley is probably, you know, more impacted than any other town in Maine. We have, as you may well know, the Penobscot Indian Nation owns 24,000 acres, half the land base in Carabasset Valley. Now, someone would say, well, what's the big deal if it goes into federal trust? Well, there's some things to consider here. One is that we would lose property tax, could potentially lose all property tax revenue on it. You know, not the end of the world, but, and then also would be able to lose all land use regulation, which this town has developed over since its inception, has done a great job with land use regulation, and we think that the growth in town has been very good and well done. So you would lose that. So, you know, those are some pretty key issues that are very important to the town. I mean, yeah, there's the casino thing out there. Hard to say where that would go, excuse me. But having said that, so those are some impact issues, and so we're very concerned about it. So as a result of that, we believe, they have not given us an official reason, but we believe that is the reason why they've posted all of their roads and trails in town. We're hopeful that, you know, this winter, with snowmobile season coming on, that we'd be able to have snowmobile trails in town. So we'll have to see, I guess. So it's discouraging, it really is.
So Dave, do you think we have an opportunity in the future to sit down at a table with these guys, or are we in a predicament where they're not going to want to talk to us?
That's an interesting question, because we've certainly made a lot of attempts to open up a dialogue, and there may even be an opportunity to convert their land to federal trust here, but obviously trail corridors are important to us, so I mean, we'd want to sit down and attempt to negotiate that. But to answer your question, they're not responding to any of our attempts to open up a dialogue right now, and hopefully that'll change. I mean, we want to see them succeed and as part of the town, but you know, obviously we can't do anything if they're not at this point willing to talk to us.
Do you think if we came to the table with money, like land use fee, something like that, is that?
I think there's all kinds of opportunities to work together. I really do. I think we all do. Lloyd Cutler, select person, Lloyd Cutler and myself have been really engaged in this whole issue for a number of months now, trying to get folks to the table to talk about this and deal with it. But right now, we're at a stalemate, unfortunately.
Well, that's that. Good, bad, or ugly, we're here to let people know what the situation is, and to please respect the fact that they've...
It is their land.
...asked us to stay off their land, and it is their land,
it
so
is
they
their
have
land.
The right to do that.
Right.
Yeah. Unfortunately, it's just a predicament. The Kiribati Valley is, again, we're unique in many ways. That's one of the ways that's kind of not in our favor to be unique, because the situation's been tenuous since they got that land in 1980.
Correct.
Yeah. Because I remember I was here when that happened. We all kind of went, what's this actually going to mean? So here we are, 40 plus years later, still wondering what it means for us. But hopefully, fingers crossed, we can all sit down and work something out
right
for everybody's benefit.